Are you right-brained or left-brained? Dear kids, you're able to diff your right hand and your left hand, or your right ear and your left ear. But what about your brain? The human brain is like a powerful computer that stores our memory and controls how we as humans think and react. It has evolved over time and features some incredibly intricate parts that scientists still struggle to understand. Also, the human brain is over 3 times as big as the brain of other mammals that are of similar body size. Each side of the brain interacts largely with just one half of the body, but for reasons that are not yet fully understood, the interaction is with opposite sides. The right side of the brain interacts with the left side of the body, and vice versa. The largest part of the human brain is called the cerebrum. The theory that you're either left-brained or right-brained means that one side of your brain is dominant. If you're mostly analytical and methodical in your thinking, you're said to be left-brained. If you tend to be more creative or artistic, you're thought to be right-brained. The left brain is more verbal, analytical, and orderly than the right brain. It's sometimes called the digital brain. It's better at things like reading, writing, and computations. The left brain is also connected to logic, sequencing, linear thinking, mathematics, facts, thinking in words. The right brain is more visual and intuitive. It's sometimes referred to as the analog brain. It has a more creative and less organized way of thinking. The right brain is also connected to imagination, holistic thinking, intuition, arts, rhythm, nonverbal cues, feelings visualization, daydreaming. We know the two sides of our brain are different, but does it necessarily follow that we have a dominant brain just as we have a dominant hand? There is no proof that this theory is correct. One of the most noticeable left brain characteristics is a tidy room. If you clean your room, you may have dominant left hemisphere controls. Many of right-brained children prefer to study alone, but as right-brained children are weak at school, they find it difficult to do sport or outdoor activities. The right hemisphere is associated with creativity, emotion and intuition. It also controls the left side of the body, so right-brained people are often left-handed. Right-brain dominant people are characterized as artistic, innovative and often random. Logic is not the only attribute of left-brain dominance. There are more specific characteristics, too. Some are unexpected. For example, left-brain people adopt lovers and love classical music. They also cannot be hypnotized. Guys, do you think there is so much for left brains? No, the right hemisphere is also associated with creativity, emotion and intuition. It also controls the left side of the body, so right-brain people are often left-handed. Right-brain dominant people are characterized as artistic, innovative and often random. The end. Thanks for watching.